A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 30th August, on the front page you have, those excluded from final NRC will get a window of 10 months. So this is regarding NRC, that is National Register of Citizens, which has been updated in Assam. We have been hearing about it continuously in news for the last few years now. So the final NRC is now going to be published on 31st of August. So there will be people who will be excluded from this NRC, National Register of Citizens, which is actually an exercise of determining citizenship of people of Assam. So those whose name do not come in the list means they are not citizens of Assam. So they have to be sent to detention centers then. But now it has been announced that those who are excluded from final NRC will get a window of 10 months. So they will have a time frame of 10 months. Only after that they would be put in detention centers. This is there. Then next is Russia set to offer submarines during Modi Putin summit. So this is regarding the summit which will take place at Vladivostok next week between Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Russian President Vladimir Putin. So it says Russia is likely to offer submarines sale to India, the conventional submarines. So these can be purchased on government to government route. So this is under the 75i project of the Indian Navy. So this is the, you can see this is regarding the defense relations between India and Russia. So deal to manufacture at least 200 Ka-226T utility helicopters for the Indian Army and Air Force is likely to get a boost. Then also a manufacturing plant has been set up in India for AK-203 assault rifles of Russia. Then Russia is also likely to offer conventional submarine as we just discussed under P-75I and also an offer of Sukhoi 57 Russian 5th generation fighter aircraft. That may also be considered that and offered to India by Russia. Then this is lack of demand is hobbling the economy's animal spirit. So this is what RBI says. It stresses on need to revive investment. And this is Kandla and Adani ports have been put on security alert. So imports warn of terror threats from sea. And this is an incident which has happened here. Schoolmates shunned Dalits during midday meal. So investigation has been ordered in this incident in a UP school. And this is Patna High Court withdraws judicial work from judge. So judiciary, what steps can be taken for an erring judge? So here you can see that Patna High Court 11 judge bench has suspended order issued by a judge from the court. On page 8 you have train 18 no less than Chandrayaan. So architects of this train 18, which has been given the name Vande Bharat Express, seek a working environment free from fear. So this train 18 had come under controversy because the train has come forth in record time. It has been manufactured in India and it's a Make in India program which has successfully been completed, but then later issues were raised regarding how it deviated from the norms which it had to fulfill, but those were minor deviations done to ensure quick development of the project. That has been insisted by the architects of the Vande Bharat Express. So it resulted in a little controversy. So that's there. On page 9 you have ₹47,436 crores released for afforestation. So this is the funds which have been collected as compensation from industry for raising forest land for business. So the Union Environment Ministry has transferred this amount to 27 states for afforestation. So you should know about compensatory afforestation. An act has also been put in place in 2016. So it has been, more than a decade since the fund was devised, then the act came into force. It was under the Supreme Court ruling that compensatory afforestation fund was established, CAMPA as it is called, compensatory afforestation management. Then below you have Fit India movement kicked off on National Sports Day. So Fit India movement has been launched by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. And he said that healthy individuals, families and society would be the ones to make new India, fit India, and urged people to make fitness their lifestyle. On the editorial page, the first editorial is law and opinion. So this is regarding how the Supreme Court should decide on Kashmir without being swayed by popular mood. So we had seen yesterday on front page that the Article 370 revocation case has been, petitions have been filed in Supreme Court on revocation of Article 370 from Jammu and Kashmir. So Supreme Court has transferred this case to 5-judge bench. 3-judge bench put forth this case for a 5-judge bench. The CJI was the head in the 3-judge bench too. So now the 5-judge bench of the Supreme Court will hear this matter. And we had seen how yesterday also Attorney General and Solicitor General, they asked the Supreme Court to tread with caution because anything which it says may be used at United Nations. But then that is for the government to realize that the step which it takes will have repercussions, not for the judiciary to not fulfill its duty of adjudicating in a free environment. Then this is tinkering for optics. So this is regarding the latest FDI rule changes which have taken place. So this article, this editorial says that these changes may not be enough to draw a rush of investments. We had seen that also yesterday in news, how FDI norms have been relaxed for single brand retail, for contract manufacturing in the country, etc. Then this, the lead article is on dilution, bifurcation and special status. So first, Article 370 has been revoked, so special status has been revoked as such from Jammu and Kashmir. The norms have been diluted and the state has been bifurcated into two union territories. So it is said J&K's perceived loss and New Delhi's real gains over the center's Article 370 decision need to be objectively assessed. Pros and cons, cost-benefit analysis needs to be done of this decision. And below you have, government needs to be prudent in using RBI transfer. So RBI transfer has taken place now. We had seen 1.76 lakh crores have been transferred from the RBI to the government. So now this article says that this fund transfer provides some much needed relief and maneuverability to the beleaguered center. But now government needs to be prudent in using this fund to revive the economy. Then on the op-ed page on Fridays, you have a question with views, counter views. So today the question is, what is the right way of regulating social media? So it says, besides technological solutions, policy discussions involving the public can help fight fake news. So it's technological solutions which are being sought for regulating social media, but even involving the public can help. Then this is regarding Australia's economic woes. So it says it is time for property rights to be moved away from competing private owners to governments. So Australia has, it holds the world record among developed countries for the longest period of uninterrupted economic growth. But now there are signs that this is going to be, not going to continue because of the chaotic nature of the country's economic system presently. The most productive assets are privately owned and major decisions regarding how to use them are made by the market. So that will have its consequences. Then on page 13 you have US again expresses concern on Jammu and Kashmir. So 3 days after Prime Minister Narendra Modi and US President Donald Trump met and it was felt the situation is under control, US has again raised concerns regarding situation in Jammu and Kashmir. So this is mentioned here. You can see they are concerned about the continuing communication restrictions and detentions. And here, so it's human rights concerns which are there. This is India condemns Pakistan call for jihad. So Pakistan's recent statements regarding Kashmir are aimed at painting the situation in against India, that it's an alarming situation in India. So this is what the Ministry of External Affairs spokesperson said, and India condemns Pakistan's stance. Then below you have digital media firms say FDI norms are restrictive. So digital media firms feel that existing and new platforms will be affected because of these FDI norms. So cabinet recently announced the FDI up to 26% under government route for digital media companies that upload or stream news and current affairs. On international page you have UN warns of rising seas storm surges. So this is a draft report of United Nations which says rising global ocean water line could displace 250 million people by the year 2100. serious concerns have been raised because of such rising sea levels and storm surges, which are a consequence of climate change. And then here you have US to keep 8,600 troops in Afghanistan after peace deal. So peace deal has been negotiated between USA and Taliban, and it has been stated that now Afghanistan will see US troops continuing even after the peace deal. So President Trump says we are always going to have a presence. On business page you have rupees 2000 notes in circulation fall. So rupees 500 notes comprised more than 50% in value terms at the end of March 2019, is what RBI has stated. So rupees 2000 notes, its volume, you can see, has fallen from last year to this year, and rupees 500 notes in circulation, they have increased. Then this is regarding how the RBI ended 2018-19 with an over 1.3 lakh crore surplus. So there was a huge surplus of RBI, unprecedented compared to last year. Earlier, the fund transfers which were done to the government were to the tune of 50,000 or 33,000 crores. Now it has been 1.23 lakh crores, 1.76 lakh crores, in which the surplus comprises 1.23 lakh crores. So how this record jump came? So it said that central bank recorded a huge jump in gains from foreign exchange transactions while its interest income leapfrogged. So that detail is given here. Also, there was change in, you know, how foreign gains, foreign income gains or FDI gains are, you know, calculated. So that also resulted in thousands of crores surplus. So you tweak the calculations and you have thousands of crores in excess. Then on page 16 you have 100% FDI in coal will boost competitiveness. So central government has announced allowing 100% FDI in the coal sector. So this should enhance Coal India Limited's competitiveness and efficiency, is what has been expected. Then there's no other important news. So these were the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asha.com. Thank you.